Okay, so now we get to do something different. Normally, when we think about graphing, we think about, an x-axis and a y-axis and four quadrants and graphing that way. This is called a rectangular coordinate system. Rectangular. Or it's also called Cartesian. And I mention this because you'll see both words in the books and the directions. Rectangular coordinate system or Cartesian coordinate system. And you're used to that. But now we're going to have a new system. And it's called a polar graphing with polar coordinates. Okay? So when we graph with polar coordinates, we use a polar coordinate graphing piece of paper. And I'll put a piece of paper, a template for those graphs, so you'll have them if you're doing any homework that requires that. We're not going to use a lot of polar graphing, but it's good to know what it is. So with the graph that you see, it's like you dropped a pebble in the water, and there were concent we call them concentric circles coming out of that pebble in the water. So a circle here, and then here, and then here. And they're concentric, not the way I have them drawn, but in the picture they look pretty concentric. So that's what the grid's made up of. These lines here are just to help you, oops, help you know where you're at. And that's helpful, so we need those. Polar coordinates come in r, comma, theta, where r is a radius and theta is an angle. They usually put these in radians for the angle. I guess they could do degrees. I don't usually see that though. Okay, so the idea is that there is a pole. The pole is the origin. It's the pebble that you dropped in the water, okay? That is the pole. And then everything comes out from that pole. The polar axis is the positive x-axis. It's like the x-axis. I guess we shouldn't call it that, but it's this right here. That would be the way we're going to measure our angles from. Now, we've kind of alluded to this before, but we'll give you some examples. It's a little bit different. We don't do that much graphing, but again, you need to be familiar with it. Okay, so let's say we wanted to graph the point 2, pi over 4. What that means is you're going to go out 2 on the polar axis. So I would go one circle, two circles. It'd be right there. Right there. That's not the point though. Then we have to rotate it pi over 4. So think about pi over 2 being here, just like we did on the Cartesian coordinate system. Pi over 4 would be like right here, kind of halfway. Looks like they have it kind of marked off in thirds. And so we would want to draw our point. It would be on that second circle, and it would be right there. We would have to rotate it. Now, you don't draw that line, so I don't want to be confusing here. Oh, there goes my polar axis. But that's the point right there. Okay? So that's what we're doing with polar coordinates. We'll do a few more examples. It's a little hard to see that first circle because it's so small, but they're going out by 1 unit increments in radius. Okay? And we wanted to go out 2 circles, so there's one circle, 2 circles, and that's where we're going to put it. We have to figure out how far to rotate from the polar axis, which is right there. So we're rotating pi over 4, and that goes counterclockwise.